Hello, I am Julian Bro. I am an economist and policy specialist. We will first present the concept of market efficiency. We will then analyze the different degrees of market efficiency. We will finally move to the relationship between market efficiency and market structure. Consumers and producers gain a welfare out of a transaction. In general, consumers get to consume a product. Producers get to gain money. A market is efficient if the welfare of consumers and producers is maximized. The notion of market efficiency means that all the information in an efficient market is incorporated into the market. In this case, the price of a product reflects all the information, and the price is strictly equivalent to the real value of the product. It is a fair price. The Fama hypothesis, first formulated in 1970, states that no investor can consistently beat the market. What does it mean? This hypothesis was formulated in the context of stock markets. Stock markets are highly regulated and efficient markets. Fama postulated that the investors, or the stock traders, can only make profits above the average profit of the market for a limited amount of time. They cannot do so for a long period of time. This hypothesis is referred to as the efficient market hypothesis. If a market is perfect, buyers can buy an average mix of all stocks and make as much profits as an individual investor who would pick his stocks. This gave way from the 1980s to index funds on stock markets, funds which buy a representative sample of a certain stock market, like the Dow Jones in New York. And indeed, these index funds tend to perform as well as individual traders who put efforts in selecting the best performing stocks. But this hypothesis is more of an ideal benchmark to which to compare normal markets, which are all, at some level, inefficient, even stock markets. In reality, there are indeed different levels of market efficiency, depending on the degree of efficiency of the market and on the market structure. The degree of efficiency depends chiefly on the dispersion of information. If information is highly dispersed, the price will reflect less closely the value of the product. If information is highly concentrated, the price will reflect more closely the value of the product. For instance, my market for grocery stores has very dispersed information. I need to walk for 2 hours in order to visit all grocery stores and check all the prices for milk. Conversely, the stock market has very concentrated information. I can watch a computer terminal and get price information almost instantly for all stocks. The efficiency of a market also depends on a related criterion, the market structure. The more market power there is on a market, the less efficient a market will be. As a consequence, oligopolies and monopolies lead to inefficiencies. Market power affects market structures. There are several types of market structures. They are defined by the degree of concentration of producers. If there is an infinite amount of producers on a perfectly functioning market, one will talk about a perfectly competitive market. If there is a finite number of competitors, we will talk about monopolistic competition. With few competitors, the rise in market power gives way to an oligopoly. With a single producer, this is a monopoly. But attention, there are some common mistakes here. First mistake, they're actually all perfectly efficient markets. In reality, Fama made a hypothesis. In reality, there are always varying degrees of efficiency, and even stock markets are not perfectly efficient. Second mistake, the price is always the fair price. In reality, the price will vary depending on the dispersion of information and the market structure. Time for a quick exercise. Which market is more efficient? The stock market, the flea market, or the supermarket? In this case, we will envision the supermarket not as a company, but as a market for goods, where several producers display their products. Let's examine those three markets according to our two criteria: dispersion of information and market structure. What about the stock market? Information is highly concentrated. I can access it instantly on a computer terminal. And the market structure is very close to perfect competition with many traders. The flea market. The information is highly dispersed. I need to walk over each stand and ask each seller to have prices. The market structure? It is an oligopolistic competition. The number of participants to the flea market is limited by its size. The supermarket? The information is semi-dispersed. I need to walk the aisles in order to get price information, but products will be grouped by aisles, which will make it quicker. The market structure? Also an oligopolistic competition. There is a limited number of brands displayed. Answer 1. The stock market. A quick recap. We have seen during this class that a market is efficient if the welfare of the consumers and producers is maximized, if the price incorporates all the information, and if the price corresponds to the value of the product. In a very efficient market, no one can beat the market and make consistently more profit than its competitors. The level of efficiency of a market depends on the level of information dispersion and the level of concentration of the market structure. Thanks for watching. Check out Chegg for more resources on macroeconomics.